Good morning, and welcome back to our little gallery of sorts. Art is the reason why we're here, a very specific form of art known as the comic book. Art is often a vision into another world, and today's perfectly depicted other world shall be found in the Twilight Zone. Before we move into that particular vision, let's begin with the street where evil dwelt. Behold our principal evil for this story. American thief Adam Gore, traveling the streets of Damascus. Some fellow folks of ill repute warn him of her, some mysterious presence that will mean he too shall be behind bars soon enough. We soon see that presence appear to the criminals, a ghostly woman beckoning them to leave their safety, which would result in their immediate arrest and execution. Adam Gore, on the streets of Cairo after completing a job, spots the ghostly figure in a less ghostly capacity, and is more than a little intrigued. The strange, beautiful woman leads him to a boat back to Damascus, where he continues following. Fortunately, she drops a business card with her name, Soja, and an address where he can find her. Unfortunately, the address leads him right back to the other cutthroats, although they're not surprised to see him again. Indeed, they've all encountered Soja. Each month she has a new trick to pull on them, this time being the business card, and her voice echoing in his head about finding her. The criminals tell him of Soja's method to this madness, of how as soon as one leaves their sanctuary, they immediately begin confessing their crimes to the nearest policeman. Why at this point and not some other? Because the statute of limitations on their crimes are coming up, and indeed, the same happens to Adam Gore as he flees the sanctuary in pursuit of her voice. She tells him that she can only be found when he is a good man, who confesses all the terrible things he's done before it's too late. And indeed, Adam becomes a changed man, from principal evil to principal good. And indeed, Adam finally meets Soja, in the form of a statue of the Scales of Justice. After a history lesson of doomsday prophecies throughout human history, we close out in our cover story. Presented to you now, this piece of art on exhibit at the local night gallery, Creatures on Canvas. In a Paris art gallery, a thief seeks to steal a painting by renowned artist André Picot. When a night watchman catches him in the act, the thief murders the guard and takes the painting. This particular piece was significant for Picot, the last painting he had done before an accident took his hand. Picot underestimated just how skilled an artist he is, for as he stands in the gallery, he soon hears his paintings talking to him, and drawing him into the world he had drawn. The figures he had given life to were witnesses to the murder, although they could not get a good look. André goes on a tour of his past works, seeking out anyone who can identify the murderer and thief. He finally finds one who can, his own self-portrait, who sadly is murdered himself within the painting by that killer, Picot's best friend, who stole it for material gain. Angry that Picot had let such a valuable piece be put on public display, Picot forces the painting version of his friend off a terrace, and when confronted in the real world, the same happens to the original. A still life recreated in perfect detail. Or rather, in cases like this, it would be more appropriate to say, a still death. This work of art now available for public exhibition in the Twilight Zone.